when people find out how many chickens I have, they usually ask me, Sam, why do you have so many chickens? And they're expecting me to say, well, because of all the eggs, or because I just really like chickens. And that's true. But the real answer is deeper than that. The chickens are absolutely essential. They're the cornerstone of my entire food production system. And that brings about something that people don't always think about that often. It all comes down to soil biology. Today, I'm going to share with you why I expanded my flock numbers so dramatically, why my background in nutrition changed how I see farming, and why you're going to see more content about things like soil biology here on the channel. I'll give you a little bit of context about me. Before I was knee-deep in chicken manure and compost and harvesting homegrown tomatoes, I spent several years working in the fitness and wellness industry. So yeah, I was that person. I was helping people to get fit and live their best lives, in air quotes. I was looking into macronutrients, micronutrients, the perfect timing for taking supplements, like what kind of supplements were best and most effective in the human body, all of that stuff. I was all over it. I even went to university to study this particular industry and the science behind human nutrition and biology and all of that stuff. So I found that really interesting, but it did have some limitations. But even before I was all into this from a scientific studying working perspective, I was raised by parents who were really into whole nutritious food. So I was raised in a fairly rural town where eating natural food straight from the tree or the garden was very normalized. Most people had chickens in their backyard. My best friends growing up, they had a family farm and I would spend hours and days with them roaming around and hanging out with cows and sheep and picking apples and things like that. So I had a really good foundation in whole foods and the importance of good nutrition for making human bodies strong and healthy. While I was studying at university, so I was in my late teens or early 20s, some of the things I was learning didn't entirely add up to me. And at that time, I discovered the works of Weston Price. Now, Weston Price was a dentist in the 1930s, and he wrote this little book here called, well, it's not very little, it's actually quite large and hefty to get through. But he wrote this book, it's called Nutrition and Physical Degeneration. And what he did is he traveled the world, going to visit a whole bunch of different people and tribes, and whether they had been already sort of exposed to modern foods or whether they were still following their traditional diets. And it is a fascinating book about what he discovered about their tooth health, just their general health and well-being, how strong and resilient they were as people, and what happened to people when they started incorporating processed, industrialized food into their diets, and how their teeth health, their tooth health, and their general health declined after the introduction of processed food. Now, it is a book written in the 1930s, so we have got some new information since he wrote it, and he does use some language that we wouldn't necessarily consider correct anymore, but I do highly recommend that you read this book if you can. It is a fascinating introduction to a different worldview of thinking about how food and the way that we grow it and incorporate it into our lives makes a big difference. Reading about what Weston Price discovered on his travels around the world really changed my worldview and my understanding, and it made me interested in other authors that were writing at around this time, like Sir Albert Howard and Eve Balfour. Really fascinating information, and still authors I go back to learn from today, but it really changed how I thought about food, and particularly how I considered modern food growing systems. So here's the thing. We can study human nutrition till we're blue in the face. We can understand everything that the human body could possibly need to be healthy. But if the food that we're eating doesn't have the nutrients that we need, that we know that we need in the first place, we're not going to get anywhere. And that is what has happened. As we have introduced our modern industrial farming practices, we have destroyed the whole microbiology of our soil, all of the soil food web that works together to bring those nutrients into the plants and then ultimately to us to eat them and be healthy. The nutritional composition of our food has decreased dramatically over the decades. So the food that we can go and buy to eat, it may not have what we need to be healthy. The food that we can go and buy at supermarkets or wherever else you buy your food might look perfect. It might look even better than the sorts of homegrown heritage varieties, because sometimes they can look a little bit funky. So that perfect tomato might look perfect and like it's got everything that you need, but nutritionally, it could have like hardly anything left in it because of the way that we have been farming. We've just stripped out the ability of the plants to get the nutrients, and in a lot of cases we have bred varieties of vegetables and fruits to meet different criteria than actually being really nutrient dense. So what can we do? That was the question I was faced with. What can I do to make sure I was actually being able to get good food for my family? And I tried finding good food, and you can find good food to buy, but it was getting harder and harder to find it, to be able to trust that that food was in fact being grown in a way that was healthy for me and for the ecosystem. And also it was getting really, really expensive. So I had to make a choice, and that choice was to start growing food for myself. And what I needed to make that happen was chickens. I decided that if I wanted to rebuild the soil biology in my little patch in my backyard, that I would need to use chickens to supercharge that process, because nothing really beats a chicken for really, really getting all of those biological systems moving, particularly if you only have a small space to work with where you can't bring in larger livestock animals like sheep and goats and cattle. Don't think sheep, goats and cattle would be very happy in my backyard. So chickens were the perfect solution for me. Chickens are absolutely amazing at making these great changes in soil biology. First of all, they scratch around in the soil, they aerate the soil, and they eat pest insects. And their main factor, their main function is to deposit chicken manure all around the yard and also into the chicken run compost system. And chicken manure is fantastic. So not only is it high in nitrogen, which biological systems need to do all of their functions, but it deposits organic matter as well. So chicken manure has got lots of organic matter with it. And that organic matter feeds the soil microbiology. It allows everything to start working because it's getting fed. So as the chickens cruise around doing their chickeny job, they are, as they go, everywhere they go, improving things behind them for everything else. The plants have what they need to grow healthy. The earthworms can come in as the plants put their roots down lower, and all of the soil microorganisms, the sort of stuff that we're only just beginning to discover, are there and what they do. We really have no idea the full extent of what is in the soil beneath our feet. But if all of those systems start coming back online, everything can start to work together again. And all of those nutrients that we need to be in our plants for us to eat and for the animals that we are going to eat, all of those nutrients start to become available and go into the plants, and the plants can start accumulating those nutrients. They can start making higher quality proteins. And when we eat those plants, we are getting the benefit of all of that wonderful nutrition to nourish our own bodies and make us healthier. I've been working at trying to create this biologically driven, supercharged, powerful, fertile system for several years now, and the results have been quite astounding. Most of the soil here has really improved, and the plant health has improved, the aeration in the soil and the drainage, and on the flip side, the water holding capacity of the soil has improved dramatically. So we can get a huge amount of rain come down, and instead of sitting on the surface of the ground, of the soil, like it used to do if we got a huge amount of rain, well, now, as soon as the rain stops, that water gets drained straight into the soil and held in the soil. It is truly amazing to watch these sorts of changes happen over time. It does take time. I have been working on this for years, and I can still see differences between the places that me and the chickens have been working on together for quite some time and the places where I haven't made quite as accessible to them or I haven't been focusing on. There are differences in the soil structure and smell, just the characteristics of the soil, but overall, all the soil is really, really good. It's just some is super great and some is just good. And it does take time. If you get started on a system like this, it's not something that's going to come about in 6 months or 12 months. It does take years, but you will see little improvements along the way to sort of give you faith as you continue on in this sort of framework. Soil biology drives food quality and the nutritional density of food, and chickens drive soil biology. So when I started this, I realized I would have to expand my chicken flock numbers quite substantially. So back when I started thinking about implementing the system, growing a large portion of food for my family myself, well, I don't even remember exactly how many chickens I have, but it wasn't that many. It was a normal person amount of chickens, probably about 5 chickens. And I knew I had to expand those numbers. So over time, those numbers expanded to what I have today, where I have 2 roosters and about 20 hens, and that's numbers that can fluctuate up to 35, 40 chickens if it's sort of peak breeding season. So those were a lot more chickens than I previously had. And that was quite challenging. It was a bit of a leap of faith to expand the numbers out that much because I had to change quite a lot of systems to accommodate that many chickens. But I did want that many chickens, both because I really enjoy chickens, but also because the more chickens, the faster I was going to get the kind of results I was looking for. But I had to change things. I had to change from a coop and run system for my 5 chickens, where they would get let out in the evening, but they weren't constantly everywhere all the time, to having a full-time free range system, because I didn't have enough run space to have that many chickens happy and healthy in a contained area. So they ended up with the entire backyard, which meant I had to completely change my gardening systems so that each garden growing area was protected from the chickens. And that is a little bit of management to get the chickens to do their job of helping with the work and accelerating all that biological activity whilst keeping them away from growing crops when they are not supposed to be helping quite that much. The chickens don't just help directly with their feet and their beaks and their poop going out onto the ground. They also help indirectly by making really great compost. So I have the composting chicken run, and that is turning chicken poop and wood chips into fantastic compost. But it also allows an area for all organic wastes that we have to go out. All the kitchen scraps, all the garden scraps, weeds, grass clippings, prunings from trees, anything that will break down, no matter how long it takes to break down, can go out to the chicken composting run. And it is absolutely fantastic because when I'm taking that compost out to the garden beds, it is teeming with life and it's teeming with nutrients that the plants need to grow strong. But with all of that biological life present in that compost, I'm inoculating that into the garden beds. So they also can supercharge their biology to allow those nutrients to become available to the plants in the first place, because nutrients do have to be in a form that plants can take up in the ratios that the plants want to actually utilize them. And the better the biology in your garden soil, the better your plants are going to be able to grow and get the full range of nutrients that they require. Of course, I get incredible eggs from my chicken flock, and that is one of the reasons why I keep them. Their eggs are amazing. But ultimately, the chickens are the engine that drive the fertility of the whole system. They turn waste into fertility. They turn sort of mediocre growing conditions into living soil, which is the foundation of growing nutrient-dense food. I'm always learning new things and making new discoveries as I learn more about this whole integrated system and how it improves the whole ecosystem that we're living and working in. And I would love to share more of that journey with you guys. So I hope you want to come along for the journey as I learn more about understanding the connections between soil biology, human health, and how that can all play together in integrated farm and garden systems. Most nutrition content focuses just on the basics of what people need to eat to be healthy, or goes off on tangents, but it tends to ignore the quality of the food that we're eating in the first place, right from the how it's grown perspective. And most farm and garden content just focuses on the what and the how, and doesn't always go into the why. And I always want to know why. Why do systems work? Why does a method work? I love knowing the why. And sometimes we don't know why, but it's really fascinating just finding out as much as we can about a system. So I really hope to bring more why content to this channel. This world we live in seems to always want to divide things into opposing categories: science versus tradition, convenience versus quality, and efficiency versus relationships. And when I stand in my garden at the end of the day and I'm watching my chickens cruising out to go to bed, and I'm just standing in this sort of ecosystem that I am trying to bring into the world, I'm struck by just how radically simple this system is. And it is fantastic. I'm pushing back against that black and white thinking, that categorization of things against each other. And I'm just looking out at this beautiful garden that I'm working with my own hands in the soil. And what I'm doing is I'm insisting that everything does belong here.